Tarkov is a very in-depth game with a lot of complicated systems working in unison to give you a unique experience. From different statistics, to the gunplay, to the armor, can be a little confusing at times. But one thing in particular that I see a lot of players not fully understanding is this right here, MOA, exactly what that means, and what that number can actually do to your gameplay. So what exactly is MOA? Well, by definition, MOA stands for minute of angle, and it is 1/60th of a degree, as in like 360 degrees in a circle type thing. When it comes to firearms, it is used to determine the accuracy of a firearm with no outside interference. What I mean by outside interference is like wind blowing, or the user, you know, not being proficient with shooting the gun, or not being the best aim. And roughly one MOA, when you're looking at the actual number, is equal to 1-inch grouping at 100 yards, or in this case, we'll say meters. It's pretty close. 100 yards is about 91 meters. So what exactly does all this mean? We got Sturman here. Now imagine if we drew a circle around Sturman. That is 360 degrees. Well, you take those 360 degrees, you find 1 degree, and you cut that degree into 60 minutes. You take that minute, you take the top portion and the bottom portion of it, like how like a triangle is, and you extend those lines all the way out. That is one MOA. As you get further from the firearm, the minute of angle becomes larger. So what exactly does all this mean? Well, here, set up a little test. You see I'm on customs. I have just over 100 meters away. So a little longer than 100 yards. We have this M4. Take a look at the stats, and it's 2.34 MOA. So it should make a roughly 2.34 inch grouping at 100 yards. So we can expect the grouping to be a little bit more. So looking over, we're gonna try to find a nice solid aiming point to use. And we're gonna use this little thing that kind of looks like a D. Holding the breath, timing the breaths. I'm gonna take shot as soon as I am on that corner. Do this for all the shots and run up over. And you see this isn't an exact science because I am shooting, so there obviously is outside interference that could come. But as you can see here, it's a pretty tight grouping. You can say roughly 2.5 inches. A little bit more, obviously, because we're a little far away. Now to show that it works across the board, go for the next extreme. Same spot, you see, about 105 meters. But now we have this Rash 12 with an MOA of 6.88. So it should make a roughly 6.8 inch grouping at 100 yards. Same thing, go up there, take my shots, go through, reload just to make sure you get a nice testing bench. Take 5 more shots and we'll go up there and look. So now you can see the bullets didn't impact a little below where I was aiming, but if you look at the center of the impacts, so you take out of the equation bullet drop just due to length of travel, you can see it's about right there. And from that spot, it is a roughly 6.88 inch grouping across. So that's cool at 100 meters, but what about a little over 200 meters? So now we're on reserve. We're gonna aim for that red shed right there, about 218, 219 meters away. I'm gonna take the same M4, and we're gonna aim for that little cross right next to the door. A little more tedious because we had cloud coverage and whatnot, and I wanted to take the most accurate shots I was able to, but get all our shots on. As you see, once we run over, shots impacted a little low because of bullet drop just due to range. But again, if you kind of look at the center of all the impacts, it's going to be roughly 5-6 inches across. Reason being, we're taking that 2.34 MOA that we had prior, and now we're doubling it because we have doubled the length of shot. So 2.34 MOA at 100 yards. So now we're shooting over 200 yards. This 5-6 inch group that we're getting completely makes sense. Now, how do we combat this? So here you can see we have a SCAV SKS with a 7.97 MOA. If you ever have a shot where you have you come in as a SCAV and you're aiming at a PMC, you have a scope or something, and you take a shot and you're like, why am I missing? More than likely, that's the reason why. But you can see the durability is real low. Nice thing about this wipe, though, is they made it so that the repairable limit for the SCAV guns is much better. So we can take a gun like this, repair it, and now look at the MOA. 1.84. A much more usable gun at this point. So hope all this information helps, you know, understand this system a little bit better. Hopefully understand like the reason for repairing your guns and why it's so important. Understand why, you know, certain engagements with a scav isn't the best one to take, or with a scav weapon at least. And if this helped, really appreciate it. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button. I come out with new videos every Friday. I also stream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. Till then, catch you guys next time.